Hello student, today I am going to teach you about the counting sort algorithm. Counting sort algorithm is an algorithm which complexity is linear, which runs in linear time. But for a beginner, it is a little bit lengthy. Not complicated, a little bit lengthy. What is counting sort? Actually, in counting sort, we arrange the data in the sequence, and it's the term counting here is used because before performing the sorting, it first count the number of distinct element and their frequency. I am repeating it. For example, suppose there are certain number which lies between 0 and 10, and if the number range lies between 0 and 10 and there are 5 number of ones, 6 number of 2, 5 number of, suppose every number 5 number of 3, 7 number of 4, then first it will make an array of number of distinct element. First step, it will calculate there are 100 number, but all these 100 number are between 0 and 9. Many of the number are repeated ones. So first we can count the frequency, number of time or the frequency of the number in the given data set. First we count out how many times 1 has occurred, how many times 2 has occurred, how many times 3 has occurred. In like way, first we count the frequency. So after the counting, it perform the sorting. So its nature is to first enumerate the different distinct number and count their frequency. After that, it apply a certain technique which runs in linear time and perform the sorting operation. So if you take simply a look at the algorithm, it may appear that it is a very lengthy algorithm, but it may be lengthy, but it is very simple in nature. So I am first explaining you the algorithm that is used to perform the algorithm counting sort and its complexity. Then after that, I shall give you an example with which I shall explain each and every step that is used in this algorithm. So firstly, I tell you the simple step or logic behind the counting sort, that first it count the number of distinct element in the data set. Second, it count their frequency, and after that it find out the cumulative frequency. I am using the word cumulative frequency. Suppose you have 2 pens in your pencil box. After that I have given you 2 pencils, then there are 4 items in your bags. And suppose after that I give you 2 erasers also, then there are 6 items in your bag. And after that I give you 2 sharpeners, then there are 8 items in your bags. So cumulative means the item that you already have and add the newly added item. For example, if somebody has 2 rupees, I give him 5 rupees, then he has cumulatively 7 rupees. After that, if I give him 10 rupees, then he has 17 rupees. Cumulative means we add on the frequency of the previous item. So in the third step, we calculate the cumulative frequency. After adding the cumulative frequency, the last part will come that I shall explain you through the algorithm that cannot be explained in simple language, and these elements are sorted. So first, the algo, in this algo, starting from here at the first line, a loop is started. Firstly, a loop is started, and the list of unsorted item, suppose I have taken an list like this. I is equals to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here I insert element 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay. Here in the first step, I shall count the number of distinct element in the data set. So in this array, suppose this is the array, and in this array there are 3 distinct elements. There are 7 items, but there are three distinct numbers, 1, 2 and 3. So in the initial step, I is equal to 0 to k. So here, k is the number of distinct elements. Distinct elements. So here, k for 0 to k, for k is the number of distinct items, we shall initialize an array ci equals to 0. First, what will we do? We shall initialize an array c, and c is equals to 1, 2 and 3. For each, we shall initialize with 0. As starting at the start, we shall start a array c which has the k number of blocks, where k are the number of distinct elements. And at initial step, the value of ci will be equals to 0. This is I, ci will be equals to 0. After that, for j equals to 1 to length a, then for the j equal to 1, suppose here for the length of the array is equal to 6, for the length of the array, do caj equal to caj plus 1. Put caj plus 1. Here I am counting the number of times an element is occurring in the array. Here we are counting how many times 1 is occurring, how many times 2 is occurring. So after this, this will be upchain. There are 3 ones, there are 2 twos, and there are 2 threes. Okay, so after here in the step number 3 and 4, we are counting the frequency. We are counting the frequency. So in the next step, what we are doing? In the next step, ci now contains the number of element equals to I. The ci contains, as here, for c1 is equal to 3, means there are 3 ones, there are 2 twos and there are 2 threes. So this okay. And after this, in step number 6, for I is equal to 1 to k, we are calculating the cumulative frequency. As I have told you earlier, cumulative frequency means add the frequency of the previous element to the new element. So ci is equal to ci plus ci minus 1. So these are the 3 steps. Here these are very simple. First, initialize the array for number of with length equals to number of distinct element. Then after that, count the frequency of the element, and after that, calculate the cumulative frequency. And after that, now ci now contains after taking the cumulative frequency, this become equals to 3, 3 plus 2 5, and 5 plus 2 7, like this. So here c is equals to, this is the cumulative frequency, means first is 3, then 3 plus 2 5, then 5 plus 2 7. Achha, okay. 3 plus 2, chalo theek hai, aapko bata dunga main baad mein. So 3 plus 2, 5, 7. And for j equals to length down to 1, now we shall, after that, here ci now contains the number of element equal or less than 1. By calculating the cumulative frequency, we are actually counting the number of element which are equal to that element or less than that element. So cumulative frequency represent that. If I shall take one example after that the cumulative frequency of number is 5, then there are at least 5 number which are equal to that number or less than that number. So this is the very critical information and the reason behind using the cumulative frequency. After that, there are 3 steps that are involved that you have to keep in your mind before performing the counting sort. Here we shall do this loop in reverse direction from length ia down to 1. Suppose the length of the element here is 6. From 6 to 1, we shall perform bcaj. We shall assign the value aj into the bcaj. And then after that, we shall do the reduce the value of caj by 1. For every time, we reduce the value of the caj is equal to caj minus 1. This may not be clear, very much clear at this time, but after this I am going to take one example for which I shall explain the each steps very clearly. So here this in first two step, this loop will run for k time, and this loop will run for n time, because the for loop runs from 1 to length a, and this is loop again run from 1 to k. So this loop will take also run in k time, and after that this loop is taking length a down to 1, so it is will also take n time. So the time will be k plus theta k plus theta n plus theta k plus theta n. So the complexity would be equals to theta k. So the complexity will be equals to theta k plus theta n plus theta k plus theta n, or we can say that theta is equals to k plus n. So this will be the complexity of the counting sort. Okay, but after this I am going to take one example with help of which you will clearly understand this. First I am repeating the simple step, and first count the number of distinct element in the array, and after that count their note down their frequency into the list. After that calculate the cumulative frequency of the different distinct element, and after that confirm the final step. That will be I shall explain you with the example. BCAJ, assign AJ value into BCAJ, and after that CAJ minus 1, and put that value into the CAJ. So in the complexity of this one algorithm is equal to theta k plus n. Or we can, if the number of element distinct element is definitely less than n, so its complexity is theta n or of order n. So I am rubbing this page, and I am going to take after that I shall explain you with an example. So this is the initial unsorted data, and there I shall give index to the each one. So 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So there are total 8 elements. Starting index is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So after this I shall initialize an array C, which is the number of distinct element here are, there is a 3, 6, 4, 1. Okay, ye kya hai? The number of distinct number. Okay. I am giving the index starting from 1 because there is a step CAJ equal to CAJ minus 1, and after 0 reaching from 0 minus 1 it will the number come will be minus 1. So instead of starting it with the 0, I start it with this index 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I have given you the reason that why I have started with 1 instead of 0, because there is a step CAJ equals to CAJ minus 1. If I start with 0, then 0 minus 1 will be a negative number. So instead of taking the 0, I am starting it with the 1. So there are 8 distinct element, and 8 total, there are total 8 numbers, and out of this 8 number there are 4 distinct number. 4 distinct number, 4 different number is okay. So in the algorithm, first step, we have initialized from I is equal to 0, 1 to k, we shall calculate, start an array C equal, which length is equals to the number of distinct elements. Since there are four distinct elements, 3, 6, 4, 1, 3, 4, 1, the only these are the distinct number. So we shall start array C with length equals to the number of distinct number. So above that we shall mark the different distinct numbers. So 1, 3, 4 and 6. Okay. So initial index. हो गया आपको इसमें length equals to 0, 1, 2, 3 length आपकी हो गई. And after this, firstly I shall count the for the step was CAJ equal to CAJ plus 1. Okay. For this array, we shall count the number of times CAJ equal to CAJ plus 1. So here, this loop will run, the second loop will run for the length of the array. The length of the array is start from j equals to 1 to length of the array, that is 8 here. J equals to 1. This condition will be checked for j equals to 1 to length of the array, that is 8 here. So when we shall perform this step, so CAJ. So here CAJ. So j equals, for j equals to 1, C of A 1 plus 1. So here C 1. At the position number 1, what means C 3. The element is C 3. So C 3 at initial step, the value of C, we have initialized this array with all the element as 0. So C 3 is equals to 0. We have initialized an array for k length with initial value equals to 0. So C3 equals to 0 plus 1. So C of AJ means C of 3 is equals to 1. So after this, the value of C3. C3 means number of distinct element I have written. So index C3 is equals to, what will it, this will be equals to 1. Okay. And after this, I shall C3 equals to 1. And after this, I shall write. Ek minute pause kar sakte ho. Ek minute pause kar dena. C3 is equals to 1. Here I want to make a correction into it. Here the array is equals to length of element. So here the length of the element is 6. This will be marked by the 6 element. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So there are number of element which are 1. So this is the number. They were starting from the 0 and up to the length of the array. So here the number of distinct element is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I have written the number. And here after counting the number, you have to mark the all the number. Even if the number lying in between the distinct number are not present in the unsorted list, even then we have to make an array up to the whole length. Of the whole length, since their element are starting from 1 are ending at 6, so we shall mark the 1 2 3 4 5 6. It is here the number 5 is not present in the list, but we have to create a array C of length from the minimum to the maximum. We shall not leave the number which are not present in the list, and we shall create a C of the length which starts with the minimum element and add at the maximum element and in continuity. So for j equals to 1, when c j equals to 1, then ca1 plus 1. So ca1 here number is 3. So c3. So c3 at start, all the element would be start with value 0. So c3 is equal to 0, 0 plus 1. So at number 3, c3, we shall mark it by the 1. Instead of 0, I shall replace it by the 1. After that, for j equals to 2, we shall again calculate with the same formula, ca2 is equals to ca2 plus 1. So ca2, at ca2 number is 6, means c6 plus 1. So at position number here, at starting c6 is equals to 0, so 0 plus 1. So this will also be, means c of 6 would be equals to 1. C6 will become equals to 1. So this will be also converted into the 1. Likewise, we shall calculate for the 4. Again, for c is equal to j equals to 3. The same formula will be applied, and CAJ is equals to CA3 plus 1. A3 is equal to 4, start with CA4, sorry, C4, because at position number A3, number element is 4, C4 plus 1, at the position C4 is equal to start with 0, because we have initialized the array of length k with initial value at 0. So c4 is equal to 0 plus 1. So c4, now c4 is equals to 1. C4 is equals to 1. Now j equals to 4, j equals to 4. For j equals to 4, again the similarly we shall calculate the value of, it's like this, we shall calculate the 1, 1 is distinct. So C4 is equal to 1, C1 is equals to C1, A4 plus 1, here C for J equals to 4, CA4 is equals to CA4 plus 1. So A4 is equals to 1. So C1 plus 1. C1 is equals to 0 plus 1. So 0 plus 1, 1. And this value will be CA4. A4 is equal to 1. So C1 is equals to 1. So this C1 is equals to 1. Next, we shall calculate the value of j equals to 5. Here is the point you should pay attention. CA5 is equal to CA5 plus 1. But CA5 is equal to C3. This point is different. Earlier, in at initial step, the value of C3 was 0, but now the C3 value has changed from 0 to 1. So this is equals to 1 plus 1. So now it is equals to 2. So CA5 is equals to 3, means C3 is equals to 2. Now C3 value will increase by 1, and it will convert into 2. So it will convert into 2. Okay. After this, for j equals to 6. For j equals to 6, 7, 8. For j equals to 6, CA6 is equal to CA6 plus 1. So 6, CA6 is equal to 4. means C4 plus 1. So yahan C4, we can write C4 is equals to C4 value. Here the C4 value is equals to 1. So 1 plus 1 means 2. So C4 value will become equals to 2. So this will become equals to 2. Now for J equals to 7. J equals to 7. C A 7 is equals to C A 7 plus 1. C A 7 is equals to 1. C 1 plus 1 means C 1. So C 1 is equals to C1 is equals to already 1. So 1 plus 1 is equals to 2. So this will also convert into 2. After that, for last step of the loop, J equals to 8. Now C A 8 equal to C A 8 plus 1. So C A 8 is equals to 4. Means C 4 plus 1. So C 4 is equals to 2. C 4 is equals to 2. So 2 plus 1 equals to 3. So C 4 is equals to 3. So now the value of 4 will increase from 2 3. C 4 is equals to 3. So after the end of the loop, we are having a matrix C, in which actually we are having the frequency of each element. These are the step may look complicated to you or lengthy to you, but you can simply check this value or verify this value with help of, because actually we are counting the frequency. There are two ones, there are zero number of twos, there are three twos, two threes, and there are three fours, and single six. Okay, so you can verify this step. There is no doubt that we are getting the result. After that, we shall initialize an array step in which we shall compute the cumulative frequency. In the cumulative frequency step, the formula used, this is the step second for loop. This is the second for loop, or the step line number 3 and 4. That is mentioned in this line number 3 and 4, that CAJ equal to CAJ plus 1. So I think that this step is clear to you. So after this step, I am moving towards the next loop, that is calculating the cumulative frequency. That is CI equals to CI plus CI minus 1. So I am rubbing this portion. Now CI is equals to CI plus CI minus 1. So simply you may perform this. So C would be equals to two plus zero, two plus two, four, four plus three, seven, seven plus zero, seven, seven plus one, eight. So this is the final CI, C matrix. This is the cumulative relative frequency array. Here the number are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One point, remember, what is the value of represent, what does this representation mean? Actually, this representation means that there are two numbers which are at least less than 1 or equals to 1. There are two numbers which are at least less than 2 or equal to 2. There are three numbers which are less than. There are four numbers which are less than 3 or equals to 3. There are four number. Sorry, there are seven numbers which are less than or equal to 4. There are 7, 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 0, 7. Okay. and there are 7 number which are less than 5 or equal to 5, and there are 8 number which are equal to 6 or less than 6. After this, we shall reach up to the last steps of the algorithm, in which there are step BCAJ is equal to BCAJ and assigning the value AJ plus 1. Okay, so here BCAJ. So in this step, BCAJ. AJ. Or after that, you are performing the AJ minus 1. These were the steps that I have mentioned in my algorithm, but that were not that clear at that time. Now, in this step, we are initializing an array B. And in this array B, this loop is also running for the length of the array, and the length of the array here is 8. So this array will also have size equals to the length of the unsorted array, but the loop will run for the value of j equals to, and it is running from the in reverse order from length a down to 1. So the array, the j is equals to 8, so it will run from j is equal to 8 to 1. Okay, because check the algorithm. In the algorithm, it is written that this for loop starts from the length of a down to 1. So for each step, we shall compute the value of that value that will be placed in the B array on the basis of these two formula. So for j is equals to 8, B C A J, for j equals to 8, I'm writing A8 is equals to A8 plus 1. Okay, so A8 is equals to 4. So A8 is equal to 4 plus 1, 5, and here B C A8 is equals to 4. Okay, and C4, check out that what is the value of C4. The value of C4 here is 7. The value of C4 is equals to B7. This value A8 is equal to 4 and 5. So B7. So at the place of the B7, we shall place the value equals to 4, A8, we have the value is 4, and add the value C4, we are having the value of 7. So C4, we are having the value 7. So at the place of 7, B7, we are having the 5. Ek second pause kar do aap. Just a second, here AJ is not AJ plus 1, it's simply AJ. So this is one is B7 is equal to 4. So B7 is equals to 4. So at the place of B7, the length of the, I'm indexing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, I'm placing the value 4. Okay, so B7, we shall write the value of 4. And after that, after this, we shall perform the same thing for the AJ equals to AJ minus 1 and AJ minus 1. After that, we shall calculate the value of for J equals to 7. Similarly, so the BCA 7 is equals to A7. So A7 is equals to 1. A7 is equal to 1, so B of C A7 is equal to 1, so BC1, C1 is equals to 2, So at position number B2, we shall put the value 1. Okay. Similarly, we shall calculate the value for 6. I am rubbing this part. For the value 6, for C equal to 6, the same process will be repeated. For A equals to 6, the value is equal to 4, and B, C, A 6 is equal to 4 again. So C4 is equals to 7. So A 6 is equal to 8. One second. And the ring was 6. A6 is equal to 4 again 4. And AJ is equal to AJ minus 1. And this step, every step, we shall change the value of AJ minus 1. So value of AJ will change to by 1. So in this step, AJ is equals to A4. AJ value has changed to, instead of 6, it will convert to AJ minus 1. Because after every step, a step is written AJ equals to AJ minus 1. So after this, the value of AJ would be equals to AJ minus 1. So this AJ will be equals to AJ minus 1. So this will become equals to AJ minus 1. So after AJ equals to AJ minus 1. So means the value will update. Here we shall change the value. J is equal to 7. So A7 value would be A7 minus 1. Means A7 value was here 4. So 4 minus A7 was value was, suppose A7 value was how much? Here I am writing the A7 minus 1 for J is equal to 7. A7 was equal to 1. So A7 is equal to 1. 1 minus 1 means will be 0. 1 minus 1 equals to 0. After each iteration, if we use the 1 value, then that value is reduced by 1. So this will become equals to 0. When you put one element in the list, then that frequency is reduced by that number. So after this, the number will reduce by 1 value. And after that, the number will be, here it will be equals to 0. Eliminate. So after putting all this number, similarly the BCAJ is 6. So 6, A6 will be equals to, at this point I want to give you that here in the, while writing the formula, second formula, I have mistakenly left the C symbol here, that the C loop, and because of that I am starting from this portion, from the position number 8. So at the position number 8, the loop will start from the length of array to the length A to the 1, means the length of the array here is equal to 8, and from, we move from in reverse direction from the length of the array to the position number 1. So the first formula is BCAJ equals to AJ my AJ and BCAJ. So BCAJ may, we are putting the value of J equals to 8. So BCA8 equals to A8, and the A8 is equals to 4. A8 is equals to 4. So we have replaced A8 by 4 here and 4 here. After that, the value of C4. The C4 here is equals to 7. The value of C4 is equals to 7. So at position number B7, we are placing the element 4. Here we were correct, but at the second expression, we left the symbol C. So now we are putting the value in the formula. The second formula is CAJ equal to CAJ minus 1. Then CAJ, putting the value of AJ, J equals to 8, CA8 minus 1. And A, position number A8, the value is equals to 4. So value of C4 is equal to C4 minus 1. And the value of C4 is equal to 7. So this value is 7, and equals to 7 minus 1 will be equals to 6, will become 6. So after that, the value of value 7 is C4, means C4, this value will change from 7 to 6. This can be explained very simply. Here actually what we are doing, we are picking one element and we are placing into the newly empty array. And when, since this is a cumulative frequency, cumulative frequency matlab means the total number of element which are less than that element or equal to that number. If we are picking one number and putting it into this array, it means that number should not be calculated in this cumulative frequency, and so we shall reduce this value Caj by C minus 1, means we shall reduce the cumulative frequency by value 1. So after this, the value of this cumulative frequency array C has been updated at position number 4. It has been decreased by value 1 at position number 1, 4, and from value 7 to the 6. Now we shall repeat the same step for j equals to 7. I am just deleting the variable place, and just in place of 8, I am writing the 7. The rest of the part will be the same. So here, I am just rubbing that part. So now the value is 7, CA7. Now for A7, the value is equals to 1. So this will be equals to 1, and this will be also replaced by the 1. And at position number C1, the value is equals to 2. So at B2, the value would be equals to 1. So value at B2 will be equals to 1, correct? And after that, we shall compute the value of Caj equal to Caj minus 1 at place, since this loop is running for j equals to 7. So we shall place this value A7 and 7. A7 is equals to 1. So this will be A7 is equal to 1. So the frequency of the C is j for A, j equals 7 is equal to 1. So C1 value will be equals to C1 minus 1. Cumulative frequency of C1 is equals to 2. 2 minus 1 is equals to 1. So the value of this cumulative frequency array at position number 1, the value will update from 2 to 1. Okay. So after that, we have got two number. And after this, we are placing this number here. Now we shall run this loop for j equals to 6. I am rubbing this part and writing down clearly. For j equals to 6, B, C, A, J, I am writing directly 6, A6. So here A6 is equals to 4. This will be 4, B, C, A6 is equal to 4. So after this, C4. Now C4 is equal to 6, means B6 is to 4. So the value at position number 6 would be equals to 4. Okay. And C of A J is equal to C A J minus 1. So I am writing directly J equal to 6 here. So replacing J by 6, 6 minus 1. A6 is equal to 4, so means C4 minus 1. So C4 minus 1, C4 is equals to 6. C4 is equal to 6 minus 1. So this will become equal to 5. So C4 will become equals to 5. So value of this array will 6 update from 6 to 5. Okay. And after that, we shall place the value of B6 is equal to 4. We have already done with this. Okay. Right. After that, we shall run the loop for J equals to 5. Again, B, C, A, 5 is equals to A, 5. A, 5 is equals to 3. And B, C, or A5 is equal to 3, so 3. C3 is equals to 4, so B4 is equal to 3. So B4 is equals to 3, right? Now we shall come check the value here. A, C, A, J is equals to C, A, j minus 1. So caj is equals to caj, c j value is here is 5, so means c5 is equal to c5 minus 1. At position number 5 the value is 7, so 7 minus 1 is equals to 6. So at position number 6 we shall reduce the value by 6. Okay, and we have run the loop for the value j equals to 5. After this, for same process will be repeated for 4. I'm just rubbing this part. For j equals to 4. So a 4, 4 is equals to 1. And yeah, this will become 1. Now c1 is equals to 1. C1 is equals to 1. So b1 is equals to 1. So at position number 1 we shall place the value b1 is equals to 1. After that we shall place c a j is equals to c a j minus 1. So j is equal to 4, so c a 4 is equal to c a 4 minus 1. So a 4 is equals to 1, a 4 is equals to 1, c 1 minus 1. So c 1 is equals to already 1, means 1 minus 1, it means 0. So at position number 1 we shall update this value by 1 to 0, and after this step we shall start the same loop for j equals to 3. For j equals to 3, b c a j is equal to a j, and this b c a 3 a 3. Okay, a 3 is equals to 4, so b c a 3 is equal to 4. So this c4 is equals to 5, so b5 would become equals to 4. So at position number b5 we are placing the value 4. Okay, and this way caj minus 1, so aj we know we are running for 3, ca3 minus 1, so c a3 is equals to 4, it means c4 minus 1, c4 is equals to 5, so 5 minus 1 is equals to 4. So c4 value will update from 5 to 4. Okay, after that we shall run the loop for j equals to 2. J equals to 2, I am just rubbing this part. J equals to 2, so j equals to 2. Now a2 is equals to 6, a2 is equals to 6, so c6 is equals to 8 means b8 is equals to 6. So we shall place a8 is equal to 6, and similarly for j is equal to 2. C2 is equals to 2 minus 1, so it will become equals to 2 minus 1, 1. So at the value place number c2, the value will reduce to 1, so instead of 2 it become 1. Okay, after the last step and the final step for j equals to 1, which will be the end of the loop. For j equals to 1, b c a j a j, so equals to a j equals to 1, a 1. So a1 is equals to 3. So it is equal to 3, or bc, a1 is equal to 3. So c3 is equals to 4. C3 is equal to 4. So b4, we have already placed the value of is equal to c3. aj equals to 1, a1 is value is 3, c3. Oh, last time we have not reduced c3, it was 3. We have not reduced c3. So c3, b3 is equals to 3, b3 is equal to 3. In last step, I mistakenly not rubbed this page portion. So b3 is equals to 3. And after that, caj is equal to caj minus 1. So caj is equals to aj, j for j equals to 1, ca1 minus 1. So a1 is equal to 3, c3 minus 1. So this part will be c3 equals to c3 minus 1, c3 minus c3 is equal to 3 minus 1. So it will become equal to 2. Okay, right? So after this, we have find out that the value here is the array, the number are sorted 1, 1, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, and then 6. So here, using the counting sort, the number have been sorted because then 1, 1 are coming together, then 3, 3, then 4, 4, 4, and finally the 6. So in counting sort, what we do, this is the very simple technique, and you can check and verify it by simple common sense along by using this. Just this step is necessary. Many times it happens that student perform this step BCAJ and leave this step CAJ is equal to CAJ minus 1. But actually, this is the cumulative table, cumulative frequency array. And if you leave this portion, you will not get the correct index in the next step if you will not reduce this value. So after the result, you are getting the sorted array. I am just giving you a brief summary. In first step, we calculate the number of distinct element. In the second loop, we calculate their frequency, how many times they are occurring. In the third phase, we calculate the cumulative frequency of that number. And after that, finally, we are performing these two steps with help of which we are sorting the number into the array B. That's all. Thank you.